Do you want to sell products on eBay? If so, I will share with you how you can easily set up an account on the site and how to change your profile as a buyer to a seller profile. In the video, we will also discuss adding an alternative methods for receiving the money made by your sales because, as you may know, PayPal has been removed as a payment method on eBay. Hello friends, welcome back to the channel. My name is Vitan. Today I will present you the steps for setting up an eBay account that will save you time and will direct you through the whole process. In this video, we will talk about all these topics and I will explain the way you can cope with them. The most important 5 steps that you need to follow. The first one is how to set up an eBay account correctly. The second one is how to turn your eBay account into a seller account, how to access my eBay seller hub, how to link your bank account to an eBay account. Fifth, how to configure payment and return policies. Okay friends, to start with, we should create an account on eBay if we haven't one. So let's look in the top left corner. Here we can choose one of two options, to sign in or to register. If you have an account already, click the sign in button and enter your email and password. Otherwise, click register and fill in the information gaps. Enter your first name, your last name, your email and the password you have chosen. When all is completed and you press the create an account button, you already have your own account on the platform. I want to say that if you have an account on eBay that you will use for buying products, it is better to use it also for selling because you probably already have an eBay score feedback there. Actually, this score comes from purchases. People are often not informed how they can check the types of scores so that they will trust you more as a seller. Therefore, you seem to be more reliable also for eBay. You can't be a seller on eBay unless you are not reliable enough for the platform. In case you propose an eBay account which has good feedback, I am very interested to comment below, are you already sold or bought something from eBay? So you can write to me in the comments below. Number 3. Because we won't use our account only to buy and we want to sell from it, we are liable to provide more information about us. We should check on my eBay and then selling. Here, we should enter the country we live in, our address, some additional information. If we want to put in also our city, region, postal code and mobile number. Stop! It's very important to know that if you sell in marketplace in Europe, you need to put Ireland. In other cases, you will be asked from eBay to add your VAT number. If you don't have VAT number, it will be very complicated to be done and will cost you extra money. Because of that, I highly recommend using eBay.com as a beginner. After all of this is completed, your selling overview is a kind of summary where you can check our archive offers, what you've sold and what not yet. Another pretty good option is called eBay Seller Hub. You can get access to it after you make a sale on the platform. So, to think that we have made our first sale, let's write in Google my eBay Seller Hub and click to activate it if you are logged with a new account. It's more advanced version of your selling overview on eBay. After you have already completed a sale, you can press the start using Seller Hub button. If you haven't sold anything yet, a message in red will appear which reminds you that you must sell something before you can use the tool. If you prefer using my eBay selling overview, use it. 4. Now we will discuss how to link your bank information to your eBay account. As I mentioned at the beginning, eBay has replaced PayPal as a method for receiving your funds with the eBay managed payment. Also, Pioneer dropped out as a payment method in Great Britain. It is available only in USA. Now, eBay pays you directly using bank account. You can add your bank account during the registration process of wait and do that later. Only this is the way you can receive your earnings. You have to link a bank account that can be in a virtual bank such as Wise, Revolut, N26 or another one, or you can be in a physical bank. First, your bank account must be verified. Because of that, you need to provide your name, the name of the bank and your IBAN number. Once all the information about you is confirmed, eBay will send you an email telling you that all is right. In case that your bank is available on at a bank account and your information can be settled. If not, you have to add your detail in the My Bank is not on the list gap. Don't forget to ring the bell just to receive a notification when I upload new videos. Thank you. By doing that, you will protect yourself from missing existing and helpful videos. Number 5. One of the most essential things in eBay setting up account is configuring payment and return policies. To start the process, type in Google eBay business policies and then click on the page business policies on the site of eBay. After that, click on the link option in and then on the blue get started button. Sometimes a warning message in red appears explaining a problem with business policies, but typically always in good condition. Now, let's go ahead by clicking the account button in the top left corner and click account settings. That is the moment I will show you how to create the policies. Click business policies in the category selling. That next button is create policy. Use drop down to choose the type of policy you want to create, payment, return or shipping. First, we can create a payment policy. I want to mention that there are very different policies. It all depends on the supplier you use. The return policy will be different on the orders will be shipped for another period as well. For example, the product will be shipped for a longer time if you order from China instead to order from European Union. On opposite side is the payment policy. It depends on nobody else, only on you. To begin with the creating of policy, its name would be given by. Now let's name it payment policy. The policy description gap is an optional one. You don't have to write anything there. Then you should choose if that to be your default payment policy. Often more policies than one are not necessary. Here you can click to see what are the payment methods you can offer to your customer. I fully recommend putting a tick on the box required immediate payment when buyer use buy it now. That will save you effort and time because if the buyer places an order but doesn't pay for it, you have to wait and perhaps you will have prepared the product for delivery. Otherwise, if the buyer has to enter cart information before it places the order, then it can decide to miss to pay. And you will not worry about it. You have to prepare the goods or not. Just before we continue explaining how to create a return policy on eBay, if you are interested in the topic of dropshipping, I will recommend you to watch my video how I made over $20,000 from eBay with dropshipping. Now, let's discuss the process of creating a return policy on the site. It may be a little bit more challenging to develop, but it's not much. After choosing the type of policy you want to create a return one, you should enter its name. Here, you can name it, for an example, return policy for Walmart or return policy for AliExpress. Due to the platform you can choose to order from, it's good to have a different return policy for every platform or supplier that sends the products to your customers. The separated policies will navigate you when you add the product. After that, you have an option to remove the acceptance of domestic or international returns, which I don't recommend you to do. The customers often look at this detail, then they order, which may refuse them to rate your product. Here I must specify that domestic return means a return in the USA and international return means a return from any other country worldwide. Then we have to choose that time we will give you our customer to return their products. The options here are 14, 30 or 60 days. I highly recommend to use 30 days return accepted. eBay will rate your products better after allowing your return process. I don't recommend to use 14 days because eBay doesn't prefer the sellers who chosen the smallest possible period. Even you say no return accepted, you will receive return requests and need to take an action. It's the buyer right to open the return request and you can't do anything. And because of that, my suggestion is to use return accepted for 30 days always. Otherwise, if there is a serious problem with the order and the customer's claim is really trustable, we will pay for the return shipping. The last thing to choose is if the order can be replaced or exchanged. My recommendation is to click on the box because for some people it is better to receive the same or another new product instead of the refund. After following all the gaps, you can click on the save button and the policy is ready to be used. Watch this video to learn dropshipping secret and don't forget to leave a comment below to support my channel. I would be very happy if the information I shared with you was helpful. Bye for now.